in that way. All right, let's get into the show. Our first act tonight, ladies and gentlemen, well, second, if you count ducks, actually. They are a husband and wife team who have traveled to over 80 different countries performing their magic. They have appeared on Penn & Teller's Fool Us and were the grand prize winners on Sci-Fi's Wizard Wars. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Kyle and Mistie Knight.
And welcome, everybody. I'm Kyle Knight, and this is my partner in crime, but more importantly, my better half, Mistie.
Hello.
And we'd like to start things off by letting you know we know what you're thinking. You're thinking magic isn't real. It's all tricks, misdirection, illusions. Well, you might be right, but tonight we're going to explore that gray area between what's real and what's illusion.
So I thought we'd first start with what's real. That is a real cotton handkerchief. This is a real pair of scissors. And if you watch closely, you'll know for certain that that handkerchief now is being cut into two separate pieces. Now, I know that you can see that for yourself. We all can. We all know that this is reality. But you know what? Kyle and I think that reality is just a little bit overrated. And that's why I'd rather show you something impossible.
Ha! Yes, just like that. Thank you.
We're gonna have a lot of fun. We're also gonna be interactive. We're gonna have Jeff helping us a couple times during this. In fact, for this next one, I think we'll use your help. Kyle's been performing magic for over 30 years now. And in that time, he has learned his way around a deck of cards. So by now he knows all kinds of crazy sleight of hand. And that means that you should trust me when I say that you should not trust him at all.
Not at all.
So for this next one, I'm going to be on your side. It'll be my responsibility to make sure that we keep him as fair as possible. Starting with the selection of the card, let's make this hands off. In fact, we're going to have Jeff pick the card for this. Come on in.
Jeff, hearts, diamonds, clubs, and spades, ace through king. You name any card, that's the card we're going to use in this little experiment here.
Okay.
Free choice.
Seven of diamonds.
That's pretty random. You can change your mind if you'd like.
Sure. I'm gonna change it.
I'm being annoying.
Okay. Four of diamonds.
I'm gonna find the four of diamonds inside the pack. Yep. There should only be one. There was the five I saw. We're looking for. There it is. The four of diamonds. Now, in order to make this card unique, we're gonna have Jeff sign his name across the four diamonds, making it the only four diamonds in the entire world with Jeff written across the front, just like that, Jeff. Right there. That's a signature right there. Jeff's signature. Four of diamonds. Thank you so much, Jeff. All right. Keep an eye on that four of diamonds. I'm going to place it in the middle.
Now, Kyle's going to take Jeff's card and then lose it in the middle of that deck.
Very slow, very fair, just like that.
But you know what? I'm going to go ahead and tell you, if anything tricky was going to happen, right now is the moment where it would be. So we've got all eyes on you. That means no cuts, no palming, no sleight of hand. Place the card into that box very slowly. And once you've done that, we're going to take it a step further. I want to make sure you can't get to that signed card that Jeff signed his name on. We're going to wrap these rubber bands around the box, locking his card inside.
One more. All right. Wrapped in all directions.
Well, we can do better than that, right, Jeff? Let's take it one step further. Now, take this piece of foil, wrap that around the box as well. That's good, but we can do better. Place everything inside of that empty paper bag. And you know what? Just for good measure, now I want you to staple it shut. Good enough. Now this is where it gets interesting.
Now, ladies and gentlemen, she tried to make this as fair as possible. Jeff selected the card. We signed his name on it. It went undeniably back in the middle of the deck, inside the box, wrapped in rubber bands, wrapped in aluminum foil. All that would make this impossible.
Check that out.
One card, but not just any card. Pull it out. It couldn't be the four of diamonds with Jeff right across the front,
right
just
there.
Like that. Yes. There you go.
Amazing.
Thank you so much, Jeff. Thank you. Awesome.
All right, now it's trivia time.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, it's trivia time. Here's your question. What world-famous, record-selling toy was originally developed as a teaching aid for architects? Any guesses? It is indeed the Rubik's Cube. Some half billion of these have been produced worldwide, which means a lot of you guys have had one of these at some point or the other. Obviously, the object of the cube is make all the sides match. Even after a few twists and turns, it becomes much more difficult. In fact, Jeff, could you help us out here? I've got
sure.
This Rubik's Cube. Mix this up as much as possible. So mix it, lots of random twists and turns. We have to have a second cube here as well. I want you to mix this one up as well so we know it's totally random. I'll take that back when you're satisfied. All right, mix that one up. I'll even give this one some more twists and turns right there so everybody can see. You can stop whenever you're satisfied. Let me take a quick look at it. All right.
Satisfied.
Right there. Very good. Very good. All right. Let's see which one of these looks more mixed up for this little experiment. I think this one's going to be a little harder than this one, but it's your choice. Which you want to use for this?
You said this one's going to be harder?
Yeah, that's the harder. All right. We'll use the harder one. There you go. Thank you. All right, thanks for your help. You
sure.
Deborah. This one, ladies and gentlemen, is called the Rubik's Cube Challenge.
I've got something else.
Oh, let me show you this. Here you go. A little blindfold, a little eye mask will make it more impossible. Although I got this at Target. Here we go. The Rubik's Cube Challenge.
Right. Now, what Kyle's doing right now is actually very important. You see, he's studying each side of that cube, paying close attention to the exact color patterns, and then attempting to lock those images in his mind. Now, the crazy thing is, there's over 43 quintillion different possible configurations for how that cube could be mixed up. That's a real number, and that's a real fact. And that means there's no way he could know how Jeff was going to mix it up before handing it back.
All right, I'm ready. Here we go.
All right, we'll see. This is where it gets a little crazy. He's got the blindfold on, and he's attempting to solve that Rubik's Cube using those mental pictures that he just created. But he's using more than that. In fact, I'm going to tell you exactly how he's doing it. The answer to this is simple. It's algorithms. Now, what's an algorithm? It's basically a sequence of moves like a mathematical formula, where step by step, each sequence leads to another, and another, and yet another. And if every single sequence is followed precisely, it will take him down a direct path to solving that cube. But because it is so precise, that also means if he misses even one move, he would have to backtrack and start the entire sequence over again. So obviously something like this requires an immense amount of memory skill, so the closer he gets to solving, the quieter I'll get so he can focus. But keep this in mind, guys. Solving a cube this fast, that alone is amazing. But solving a cube this fast, one that Jeff mixed up while wearing a blindfold, that is magic.
All right, it's definitely harder. I should have had him pick the easier one. All right, here we go. All right.
Closer.
Feel it. Come on. All right, ladies and gentlemen, I've got it. Yes. No, don't laugh, Jeff. I wasn't trying to solve the cube. Anybody can solve the cube. I was trying to do something much more difficult. I was trying to match it to the other one. Now check it out. Every single spot on that side, a perfect match. But not just that side. That side.
Yes.
That side.
Every side.
That side. Every single side.
Eric.
Perfect. Yes.
Let us hear you in Vegas.
But for those of you who really want to see it solved, I'll do that one with my eyes closed simultaneously, just like that.
That just happened. Yes. Good job.
Yeah, don't applaud too much. That just means I had no childhood. Thank you so much.
Good job. All right. Now, whenever you see something amazing, it's not like you can really share that with somebody else, like you have something tangible. You really just have your memories, your past experiences. So we got to talking and we thought how cool it would be if we could somehow find a way to capture magic in time. And that is what we're gonna do here tonight.
Check this out, little silver tray. I'm gonna place it on top of this pole, right about here. I also have a little glass jar. Check this, a little glass jar, you can see right inside. I'm gonna take this napkin and wrap it around the outside of that jar. Watch very carefully. Wrapped up. I also have a cork for the top. I'm gonna place that cork here. There it is. Put it on top, just like this. I'll place the glass jar on top of the tray so it's isolated in space. Now, Jeff, if I was to ask you to, what would you think could fit inside that glass jar? A lot of different objects can fit inside there. It could be a book of matches, a walnut, an egg, a lime. I've got about 30 different cards here. I'm just gonna shuffle through these. You just say stop anywhere you'd like. It's your free choice. I'll just kind of shuffle through.
Stop.
Right there. Now, you kind of stop me between two of them. I've got a high one and a low one. It's your choice. You like the high one or the low one?
Low.
The low one? Here, this was yours today. Today we've stopped on a, what is that?
Golf ball.
Golf ball. Great choice, golf ball. Check this out. Golf ball, where the magic moment happens.
Golf ball. Yeah.
Check it out. It was your choice, Jeff. You stopped us on a golf ball. Everybody listen. I hear something inside there. It couldn't be, right? Let me take off this.
Yes.
Check it out. It is indeed a golf ball inside there. Yes. Come on.
But that's not the amazing part. This
Wait.
Is the amazing part.
You know what that means? If it can't fit through the mouth of the glass, that means it's too large to have come from outside, which means that it had to have appeared inside the glass at the moment that Jeff chose it. And that is why this is an impossible object, and it is magic captured in time.
Thank you. Thank you.
Incredible.
And the coolest part of this is that, Jeff, since you've been such an awesome host for all these, we are going to be giving you this. You can sit it on your desk and experience the magic for time to come.
Awesome. Thank you so much. Oh, so frustrating.
If I wasn't, like, genuinely friends with you guys, I would hate you two.
You'll never figure it out. Good
no.
So right now I've got something kind of cool I want to show you nice and close up. It's actually this puzzle. It's a solid wooden puzzle with an oak frame right here. I can take off the frame, show you guys it's completely solid, made of oak. It's actually screwed together at all four corners. I'm going to place that back over top of the pieces just like this. You can see nice snug fit just like that. I want you to watch this next one very carefully because it's called Nothing's Impossible.
A lot of people think that magic is like this simple wooden puzzle. They think the only goal is to just try to figure it out. Put all the pieces together so they fit inside this frame perfectly and then you're done. But if we let it, magic can be much more than that. You see, it can inspire us to believe that nothing's impossible, and we can apply that idea to our own lives. Just like this frame, most of us have this invisible boundary where anything outside of it seems unavailable to us and out of reach. And the different pieces of this puzzle represent the different choices that we make and paths that we take throughout our lives. One day we all must decide if we're going to stay at home or move away. Whether to go to college, what career path we should take, who we should marry, whether to have children, and what kind of parents we want to be. And in some way, every single decision that we make can have an effect on the rest of our lives. But unfortunately, there are some choices that we never even consider because we can't imagine them fitting into our lives. Somewhere along the way, we've just given up on the idea that nothing's impossible. We've stopped letting ourselves dream and pursue something more. Maybe it's because we're afraid to fail, or because we think some things are for those other people to do, not us. But at some point, no matter how impossible it may seem, we have to see if we can find a way to make those dreams fit into our lives. I know that was the case with me. Being from such a small town in Mississippi, I never dreamed that I would ever have the chance to travel the world and perform for hundreds of thousands of people like you. Because for some reason, I didn't think that's what I was supposed to do. It went against every plan I'd ever made and every plan that had been made for me. But when that opportunity was within reach, I chose to take a risk, let go of all those doubts and fears, and follow my heart. And that was the best decision I ever made. Now, over 30 years ago, when Kyle was just a young boy with big dreams, everyone told him he was crazy for saying that he was going to be in show business one day. Throughout high school and college, he kept saying that this is what he wanted to do, but everyone around him, his friends, even his family, tried to encourage him to just do something safe. Let magic just be a hobby. But Kyle, being that stubborn, hard-headed man that I know and love, he didn't listen. He kept working hard, and he dedicated his life to making this dream come true. And I'm so thankful for that, because now we can be here on this stage together. So if you only take away one thought tonight, we hope that you know. The only limits we have are the ones that we put on ourselves. Because all we really have to do is believe that nothing is impossible.
Thank you. Thank you, guys. All right, you guys ready for one more? Jeff, are you ready for one more?
I am so ready
awesome.
For one more.
We've got something kind of cool. I've got some solid metal rings. Could you check these out for me?
Sure.
Let's just grab a few. Make sure they're all completely solid right
yep.
there. It looks good. Looks good.
Looks good.
In fact, could you join me over here? We're going to
sure.
place these rings right over top of Mistie like this. So I'm going to place one over top just like this. And I've got some hardware in this little pan right here, Jeff. I'll hold on to those rings. And you
okay.
take these nuts and bolts right there.
Sure.
And bolt it on the back as quickly and as tightly as you can. We're locking her in place.
Wow, really?
Yeah, get down here and bolt that on
okay.
the back right there. I'm going to take this one up there. I put you to work here, Jeff.
Yeah, hold
another one over top just like this.
Yes.
All right. I think he's got the system. Here we go.
I'm not right wearing the right shoes for this.
No. Here you go. I'll place this one over top as well. You're always got some speed. You're good. You're good.
You're belittling me. That was patronizing.
I think so.
You're good.
You're good.
Yeah.
Another one over here, just like this. All right.
Come on. You're losing speed. I'm not very handy. How much
faster? Much faster than the one over top. All right, I'll keep on going.
Okay. Come on, catching up.
Catching up.
Yeah.
Pull one right here.
Do you have any power tools? Much easier.
Here we go. Got a ring right here. Okay. I think that's what, 5, 6, maybe 2 dozen rings replaced over top.
Yeah, 3 more now.
Okay,
and
there we go.
Shut up,
for sure.
Do you have a
full up? Okay.
Fine. Okay.
I got one more.
I got,
He's still working on it.
WD-40.
Last one.
Did you get this one?
Yeah, that's last one.
All
right. Okay.
Wait for it. Boom!
He's got it! All right. All right. Hit the fabric of the wood on, just like that. Yeah. And then erase it about this
far. You're going to force
towards you. Okay. Okay.
Okay.
It's Mistie, ladies and gentlemen! Nice outfit as well!
Woo-hoo!
Thank you so much.
Oh, my God. Thank you so much. That was awesome. Ladies and gentlemen, Kyle and Mistie Knight, how incredible was that? I love you guys. I've seen you so many times. You blow me away every single time. Keep it going, ladies and gentlemen, one more time. Give them a virtual round of applause there. That is Kyle and Mistie Knight. Unbelievable. You know, I've worked with Kyle and Mistie a bunch of times in person. We've done shows on Disney Cruise Line together here in Las Vegas, corporate events, casinos, all over the country. And I got to say, every time I see him, I'm just blown away. And folks, if it's magic that you want tonight, then I'll give you some magic. I wasn't going to go here, okay? I wasn't going to bust this out. But the response in the chat, you guys are really into that. So I'm going to kind of go on the fly here, pull out a little magic trick. Ladies and gentlemen, I give you the towel vanish of mystery. Here we go. 1, 2, 3. Right? I'm going to leave the magic to the pros.